Hi, this is Andreas Achuk. I welcome you to the next online training on Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace. The subject of this training is bounce rate metric. You will get to know how this metric is defined in Adobe Analytics. You will get to know why it differs from the bounce rate metrics in other web analytics solutions. And I will also will show you how to create an alternative bounce rate metric that you may want to use going forward. Let's get started. I'm in Analysis Workspace and I will add the page dimension and I will add the out-of-the-box bounce rate metric to this table. If you thought that the bounce rate metric in Adobe Analytics is defined the way that when visitors come to the site, viewed only one page and then left the site, and then the bounce rate metric is incremented, this is not always the case. And I will explain to you why the bounce rate metric is calculated in Adobe Analytics in a different way. I will need to first walk you through the metrics the bounce rate metric is based on. The bounce rate metric is defined as number of bounces divided by number of entries. Bounces is a visit that consists of a single server call. Entries represents the number of times a given value is captured as the first value in a visit. So for example, if I come to the home page and this is my first page, and then I click through to the account page, then the entries metric will be incremented for the home page, since this was the first value that was captured within a visit for the page dimension. If I come to the home page and then leave the site, then it could be a bounce rate. So one bounce could be count, but only under certain conditions. The condition is that there should be only a single server call sent from that page. So when I come to the home page, one server call is sent to notify Adobe Analytics that a visitor viewed the home page. And if afterwards the visitor leaves the site, then the bounces metric will be incremented. However, if you have any type of on-page tracking implementation that results in an STL or custom link track and server call, then the bounces may not be incremented. For example, if the home page has a tracking implementation for on-click events on a certain area of the page, for example, there is a form, and if a visitor clicks on the form or in any of the fields in the form, and then the second server call, STL, custom link server call, is sent to Adobe Analytics, then such visit will not be considered as a bounce. So since the second server call happened, then the bounce will not be incremented, and as a result, the bounce rate will not be considered for that visit. This is the key difference in comparison to other web analytics solutions. So let me create the bounce rate metric so that we will make sure that it's calculated as I explained. I will call it bounce rate. Bounce is divided by entries. I will set the percent format and we'll add those two metrics to the definition area and we'll save it. And I will look for the new metric and we'll add it next to the default bounce rate metric. As you can see, the numbers are the same. They match each other. So the formula is accurate. Now, what if you don't want to consider secondary server calls as engagement? So for example, many sites have Adobe Analytics implemented for tracking the scrolling events. For example, when a visitor scrolls the page till 50%, or then a circle is sent to notify Adobe that the visitor actually viewed the page and probably scrolled it till half of the page. Then when the visitor continues scrolling and probably scroll till the end of the page, another circle is sent so that the analyst will know how many visitors or how many visits ended with the scroll until the very end of the page. In some cases, this makes sense, and this makes sense from the engagement standpoint, but in some cases, this doesn't make sense as it's not necessarily reflect the real engagement. In some scenarios, you really want the visitors either to go to another page or probably view more than one page after the landing page, etc. So in this case, you will not be able to use the bounce rate to get what you want, but you can create an alternative version of the bounce rate. And for this purpose, we will need to use another metric, which is called single page visit. This metric is also available by default, and it's defined as the number of visits with a single page view. So here, it's important that there was a page view. Doesn't matter what type of STL custom link server calls are happening, this metric counts only page view server calls. So in order to update our bounce rate, we will need to create the bounce rate as single page visits divided by entries. Let's do that together. Bounce rate, single page visits divided by entries. Again, percent format. And we'll need to find this metric. There you go. And I will add it together with the bounce rates so that we can compare the values. So now we can see that for two pages, Internet Wi-Fi and Internet LAN, the original default metric of the bounce rate and the updated custom bounce rate metrics are showing dramatically different values. And this is because on these two pages, there are some on-page events fired. And this is why the bounce rate is much lower. And if this is not what you consider engagement, then you may want to use this alternative calculated metric for bounce rate that is based on single page visits. Hope now you understood the difference between the default bounce rate metric in Adobe Analytics and the one that I showed you. If you realize that you could misinterpret your analysis in Adobe Analytics, now you have a recipe that you can use going forward. Let me know if you have any questions or any comments, feedbacks. I would appreciate if you can add your comments under this video. Hope this was helpful. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your time, and talk to you next time. Bye.